Okay, we're back live here at NAB. I'm John Furrier, the founder of SiliconANGLE.com. This is SiliconANGLE.TV's The Cube, our flagship telecast. We go out to the events, set up our anchor desk, and talk to the smartest people we can find, extract the signal from the noise, cover the news, provide our opinion, as always, and our analysis. And my co-host is...
I'm Dave Vellante of Wikibon.org. And John, we're here with Wim DeWispeler, who is the CEO and founder of AmpliData. John, we've been talking for years now about cloud and storage and how the whole paradigm is changing. And
Yeah, I mean, Dave, I mean, when we first started working together in 2010, we saw that storage was going to be hot in a bigger way than most people saw it. And we started working on our innovative business model, SiliconANGLE and Wikibon. And clearly, that was not on everyone's radar. We called storage as sexy. Now, with cloud and storage, it's absolutely totally mainstream. All the top guys out there, like Google, are saying cloud, mobile, and social. Storage is the fundamental bottleneck for real-time business, real-time information, real-time media. And here at NAB, you know, you can't walk around without bumping into some sort of new camera, editing station, some new technology that creates bigger, fatter, more content that needs storage and processing. So I think, Wim, that's a lead into you. I mean, you guys are under the covers solving these problems. Talk about the tsunami of big data. And when we say big, we mean like it's big. Yeah, file size data.
Absolutely. That's what we're focusing on. So how do you store petabytes of data reliably? So you never want to lose that data, and you want to store it reliably on a disk-based storage system. And disks, yeah, are still mechanical devices, so you know one day they're going to fail, and you need to protect yourself against that. Second thing is, like, how do you scale such a system to petabytes? We've seen initially, we've been focusing on online applications, such as social media applications, storing massive amounts of photos and small videos that people are uploading. That generates, like, yeah, petabytes of data. Online archives of data. One of our customers is Jazz Montreux, that they've been digitizing all of their video content of the last 40 years. And they've put this on an AmpliData storage system, which makes it readily available now to stream to jazz cafes and so forth. So this is really driving, like, the requirement for storing petabytes of data online.
Talk about the market dynamics, because right now most people think of storage as, oh, I have a hard disk on my computer, and or part of some big company back office operation in the data center, monster, you know, drives, you know, from buying, whether they're buying from EMC, NetApp, and so these are big systems that sit back there. And yeah, they serve up information, but no one really thought of them as critical infrastructure. Talk about, in the market today, how storage has evolved to become so critical in the business operations of the marketplace.
Yeah, well, really, it's the data volume that makes that customers are running quite a lot of issues now. Traditional storage systems, whether it's block-based storage system or file-based storage systems, have never been built to store petabytes of data. Block-based storage systems, typically you're going to set a group of disks in a RAID set to protect yourself against a failure of a disk. And the technology has evolved here. RAID 5, RAID 6 gives you protection against two disk failures. Now, when you're storing petabytes of data, you want to protect, or you want to use these high-capacity drives that are available in the market now. You want to use the 3 to 4 terabyte drives. Now, typically, you need to put them in a RAID set, 10 drives in a set, for instance, that gives you like 40 terabytes worth of capacity. That doesn't bring you to petabytes. So really, you need quite a lot of storage management software and capability around that to scale out that system. These traditional systems don't offer you that capability. File-based storage systems, on the other hand, also have their limitations. Like typical NAS-type systems, they're not built for petabytes. File-based storage requires you to organize your files in a certain directory structure, which you need to set up beforehand, and that has several limitations. You have limitations in number of directories that you can create, number of files per directory, and all of that. So those are the limitations that you run into, and it's very difficult in this unstructured big data. It's very difficult to predict what kind of data you're going to be storing and how you're going to organize that data. So really, what we bring into the market here is an object storage system, which gives you like a global namespace that is scalable without limits, which you can keep on storing your data without running into the limits of typical block or file-based storage systems.
Dave, you've been covering storage in this area really closely. Obviously, block, object, obviously some differences. We've had Vishal Sikka talk about object, kind of not in a positive way. What's your angle on this?
So, John, RAID was initially introduced because of the problems with mechanical disk drives. They were error-prone, and RAID essentially solved that problem when drives were, you know, a couple gig. The problem now has become that disk drives are so large, as Wim was saying. You're talking about 3 or 4 terabyte drives. How long does it take to rebuild a 3 or 4 terabyte drive?
Well, typically in a traditional RAID system, it can take you up to like 2 days.
Okay, so if you have 2 days.
Days,
so
days, if you, days
if you
not
have,
hours.
If you have RAID 5 and a 30 minutes. Terabyte drive is going to take a month. So if you have a single parity, now during that rebuild process, you're exposed. So with today's bit error rates and soft bit error rates, the probability of losing data is almost a certainty, right?
Yep.
So you've attacked that problem and others with this notion of bringing in Reed-Solomon coding and erasure coding, which are well known. It's math, basically bringing math to solve the problem. John mentioned Vishal Sikka. The challenge is it's very math heavy, and so there are performance concerns. So talk about that a little bit.
Correct. So basically to overcome these issues with traditional RAID, typical object storage systems initially were storing multiple copies of data. So if you look at what Amazon and Google and the others are doing, whenever you upload a picture, they immediately after the fact, they create like 3-4 copies of that picture, spread across multiple disks, and that protects you against a failure of a single disk.
Seagate loves that.
Sure, because for every terabyte of data stored, you need actually 4 terabytes of disk capacity. So that's very expensive, also requires a lot of power, floor space, and all of that. So this is how we started using erasure coding to reduce that overhead. Really, with erasure coding, and you mentioned Reed-Solomon as a typical example of erasure coding, you can reduce that overhead. You can tune to a certain availability policy, like 2, 3, 4 disk failure protection with little overhead. Now, the problem with traditional erasure coding systems like the Reed-Solomon is that those are very difficult to make performing or performant. It's very difficult to get to the multi-gigabyte per second throughput rates that are required, like here we are at the NAB show. Those are required for media and entertainment. So that is why AmpliData within its AmpliStore system is using a new erasure coding technology, which is called rateless erasure coding. And this really allows us to put the throttle on throughput. We are now getting, on our controls, we're filling 10 gigabit Ethernet interfaces. So we're getting beyond 700 megabytes a second throughput per controller. And across a whole system, by adding multiple controllers, we can scale that out to tens of gigabytes per second of data that can be put in the system and retrieved out of the system.
So yeah, I'd love to dig into that a little bit more, but I don't have a ton of time here, but my friend, he may not be your friend, but my friend Chris Gladwin says, RAID is dead. Do you agree?
RAID is dead, absolutely. I agree with that. So
Reed Solomon, you guys have some common ground, a lot of common ground, actually.
absolutely. And we were big promoters of object storage systems because they solve quite a lot of the issues in terms of scalability. The one thing where we as AmpliData have gone beyond is so we fix the durability problem, we fix the scalability problem, and in addition to that, with our newest release of our software, the AmpliStore XT controllers, which stands for extreme throughput, we've also solved that throughput problem, which is really key in the markets where we were operating here. This allows us to deliver the performance that is required for a storage system in addition to all of these nice benefits of object storage.
Well, essentially, you're betting on Intel, right?
I mean, we're very close to Intel because to get to that performance, we've optimized our technology to make maximum use of the capabilities within the Intel Xeon processors.
Well, so it's a Moore's law bet, I should really say. I mean, Intel, obviously Intel, but it's you're basically betting that the math heaviness of your system is going to be overcome by processing power.
Absolutely. Right. So we're having heavy on math, but
it's a good bet.
It's
a good bet.
It's a good bet. And so really we've gotten to the point by leveraging the Intel CPUs that we now deliver the performance necessary for media entertainment. We can now do the newest movies now are recorded in 4K frames, stereoscopic, so that doubles the amount of data. And now we're going to frame rates that go up to 120 frames a second. So this is like fivefold the traditional 24 frames.
So as you forecast that out, you know, because as John mentioned, CTO of SAP had some sort of negative comments about object store, said it didn't scale, didn't perform well. Do you see the use cases for object storage going beyond archiving, or will it be confined to that for some time?
They definitely go beyond the archiving. And so with the performance numbers I've given you, we have implementations at customers where the Ampli store can be used as the primary storage target for the data streams. So definitely we go beyond archiving. And I would say definitely object storage is the next big thing. So this is going to be the technology of choice for big data of the future.
Because it dramatically simplifies the whole storage environment. We should mention that, obviously, right?
That's absolutely. It overcomes limits of rate of file-based storage systems. It gives you petabyte scale, high durability, at the low total cost of ownership.
No more LUNs.
No more LUNs. Okay, no more management.
Wim, the CEO, founder of Ampli-Data, storage is hot, storage is sexy, it's relevant, and it's going to be bigger. Bigger frames in each piece of data that they're recording in on video, et cetera. Thanks for joining us on theCUBE. This is theCUBE at the Intel Studio Experience. Thanks to Intel for supporting us, to coming taking our show out here to NAB. We'll be here for 3 days. I'm John Furrier with Dave Vellante from SiliconANGLE.com, Wikibon, theCUBE.